Have you been using Microsoft Copilot? Do you ever get a little frustrated because it's not giving you the responses you want, especially compared to maybe ChatGPT? I'm here to tell you that you are using Copilot wrong, and I am going to teach you how to use it the right way. In Copilot, you can create 5 different types of prompts to get all sorts of different things that you need in your everyday life. The first prompt I'm going to do is called a create prompt. And I'm gonna start by asking Copilot for something that I need created. My boyfriend and I are planning on going on a European vacation, and I would like Copilot to build me an itinerary. So I'm gonna ask Copilot to do that. Looks like it's giving me 1 to 3 days in London. It's just telling me to go there and go a few places. I guess we're going for 10 days, and it looks like we're going to the Netherlands and Belgium too. Okay, so it gave me a few options here, but I'm actually not going to the Netherlands and Belgium. I was more planning on going to London, Paris, and Rome. So looks like I need to give Copilot a little bit more information. I can change my entire response here by just giving Copilot what it needs. And Copilot needs 4 different things in a prompt to give the best responses. It needs a goal, context, expectations, and a source. With these 4 things added into a prompt, I can get the exact response tailored exactly to my needs. So let's try this out. I already have a prompt created. So I am just going to create a new topic here, and I'm gonna paste this right into Copilot. It says, my boyfriend and myself are going on a romantic Europe getaway. We will be going for 10 days in fall of 2024. We wanna make stops in London, Paris, and Rome. Please include Airbnb recommendations, the best hidden gem restaurants, and top attractions. Use websites that have reviews from people who have been to these places recently. I'm gonna hit submit, and let's see if this is a little bit more tailored to what I wanna do when I go to Europe. Wow. It has already given me so much more information. I have specific Airbnb recommendations, some hidden gem restaurants and top attractions. Those are the expectations I set for Copilot. It's giving me London, Paris, and Rome, which were the 3 locations I asked for. And I can see down here, it's even giving me a map of some of these places, which is really nice. So I can see that giving Copilot just a little bit more information is going to give me responses that are tailored to exactly what I was looking for. Another prompt that you can make is for editing purposes. So this can be rewording or rewriting or even creating something like a blog post, or how about maybe an email to tell my boss, sorry boss, I'm taking a 10-day vacation. So let's make this email for my boss. Hey boss, I'm gonna take PTO and go to Europe with Bay. I'll be out of the office for 10 days in September. See ya. This doesn't sound very professional and it's kind of short. Maybe I should make it a little bit longer and a little bit more professional sounding. So I'm gonna tell Copilot, please make this email longer and more professional. I am sending this to my boss. And let's see if Copilot can maybe fix our situation. Wow, already so much better. I hope this message finds you well. Sounds very professional. I would like to request PTO for 10 days. Sounds much better than me saying, hey, I'm just gonna take my 10 days. Thank you for considering my request. This email looks much better than what I already had in mind. So looks like this is taken care of. So after my European vacation with my boyfriend, I decided it wasn't really working out. So I think I need to break up with him, and I'm gonna turn to Copilot to give me some advice. Let's head to our next prompt, which is to ask. And I'm gonna say, I need to break up with my boyfriend. I need to focus on myself right now. He is a really great guy. How should I do it? What should I say? Let's see if Copilot can help me. And Copilot to the rescue. Looks like it's even giving me advice on everything surrounding it. It's not just telling me how to break up with him, but it's also saying, choose the right time. Be honest and kind. Use I statements. Be prepared. And then it's giving me an example script. Hey, I want to talk to you about something important. It's even giving me a little bit of advice for after the conversation. I will need some self-care after this breakup. So thank you so much, Copilot, for helping me along the way. Our next prompt is to understand. And thank goodness Copilot can do this because somebody asked me on a date already. I know I just broke up with my boyfriend, but this new guy, he asked me on a date and he wants to take me to a football game, an NFL game. And I don't know very much about football or how it works. So I'm going to ask Copilot to kind of teach me what is going on with American football. There is this rule in learning called the 80-20 rule. I am going to ask Copilot to give me 20% of the information about American football to help me understand 80% of it. Let's see if I can learn a little bit about the good old gridiron right here. Oh, it's giving me information about teams and players, the objective, the field layout, key positions. That's good to know. I think I've heard of a quarterback before. Here's the information about scoring. And then it's even asking if I want to learn more. Do I have any other questions about specific rules or strategies? I don't even know what that would mean in American football, but that's okay. The last prompt I can create in Copilot is a catch-up. And this is kind of a way to get something summarized where you can grab a lot of information about something in a very concise way. So I have decided to look up a YouTube video in which I can learn more about the Jacksonville Jaguars because I know nothing about them or anything that they do or who plays for them. I barely even know what city they are in. So I am gonna use this YouTube video in Copilot, which is up in my right-hand corner of Microsoft Edge. And I really don't wanna watch this whole video. It's going to be a waste of my time because it is 21 minutes and my time is valuable. So instead, I'm going to use Copilot to generate video highlights. So I'm going to hit that generate video highlights. I'm going to let Copilot think and then, oh, look at that. Wonderful. So this video is about the Jacksonville Jaguars in 2022. Their head coach is Doug Peterson. I guess they did really bad in 2021. But they have some guy, it looks like, named Trevor Lawrence, who seems to be a big deal. He's very impressive. They've got good leadership. Trevor Lawrence's career high performances. He's a very big deal. I should do some more research on him or just look out for him maybe at the game. There was an 18-game losing streak on the road, I guess, that they broke and have done better with. And looks like they had some key wins in the final weeks and had a historic comeback in the playoffs. So it looks like Jacksonville's Jaguars are one of the best teams out there. That's what I'm understanding from this summary. So I think this was a great little summary of the video, and now I don't have to watch it. So thank you, Copilot. I am going to be ready for this date at the Jacksonville Jaguars game. Do you think Copilot is a lifesaver? Or do you find it a little bit unnecessary? If you want to learn more about Copilot, check out the Copilot cheat sheet provided by Pragmatic Works. Also, be on the lookout for my YouTube series, The Copilot Chronicles. I hope you enjoyed this YouTube video, and I will see you in the next one.